Theoretisch mal transitioning.
Transition mal.
Hallo, Friedrich.
Good
Oh, good
evening.
evening. Yeah, it's the English time now.
Yeah, but you could still say hello if people understand that.
Okay, you're right.
Hello, Jana.
Hey, welcome to the Friday Stealth Night. Is it the name now?
No.
Okay, do you have a better name?
The Death Stream.
Stream. Everybody calls the Death Stream Death Stream.
Whatever.
We have to make a creative writing tool to find out a better name. Speaking of,
Are
what?
people hearing us? Yeah.
Speaking of creative writing tool,
Writing tool.
we just saw in the stream of the hypnotic owls that they were using the questionnaire you did.
Yeah.
I'm going
I
to
remember.
post the link to their channel. If you want to take a look, it's the episode they did today, and it's
They're
rather
actually doing it now, so
they're still
don't switch.
they're still doing it. You should do it later, and it's more at the end. And I think we are going to link it. If you watch this on YouTube, we are going to link it in the comments
Probably, yeah.
in the yeah, what's the name in the writing below
In the
description.
description.
Yeah, and the questionnaire was a tool for creative writing that you wrote random questions developers should ask themselves about their game.
And I watched the streamer up until a minute ago, and the best part was when they transformed one of the questions into their own question. So that was what was actually behind the thing. So
Did you
ask.
remember?
No. You can watch it in the stream.
It was if a hacker steals
Right.
your game, if an evil hacker steals your game. I think how much time do you need to make it from scrap again?
Scratch, yeah.
Scratch and
And they said, what would a good hacker do with the game and
make
make
it
it, how would he or she improve it?
better. So that was amazing. Was fun to watch, I guess.
Yeah.
So yeah, big thanks to Jan and Hannes who can't hear us because they're still streaming. So we get to the next stuff. Because last week we asked which game we should play today, which you might have guessed by now. It's
Guess.
Dips.
Oh, right. Yeah. I'm a little bit slow today.
So I make a screen transition. Wait. Like this. And yeah, that's. There was a short time where Dishonored was up to Styx, but there was not much voting for Batman, and I think Origami is not that well
I
known.
don't know. Or maybe people just hate it.
Or that.
I would choose something I don't know.
Yeah, that's right, but also maybe you would, I think in those polls, if you not intend to even watch the stream,
So,
you just
just
like the
click on the
game,
name you recognize.
and you the game of you like maybe.
I think Styx was chosen because it has the name, the word shadows in it.
Totally, but I think there's also like a fan. One recommended our stream today to a person who maybe loves the game. So I
Okay.
think there's a fan base for Styx, definitely. Also, we got recommendations what to play next. One of them was.
Not sure if they are really serious, the recommendations, because those games are like from the 80s.
Yeah, I think it was about trolling, but I kind of liked Der Clue, The Clue, a game where you play a Polish thief, very, very shady stereotype. It's from Austrian Rockstar Vienna, and I think it's more like a point-and-click adventure, I think.
I think it was more than that. It was more like you could really go to each place and like I don't actually know
He looks
which
like Nicolas
genre
Cage.
it is. Totally like a fat Nicolas Cage with a fake nose.
Yeah.
So not like Nicolas Cage.
It's like Monkey Jesus Nicolas Cage.
Okay. It's heavy interface game, and but what I always saw, go back to the gallery please,
Yeah.
was the one where you actually see the place you are going to rob. I don't know if you see it here. Okay, das ist der Amiga Screenshots. You plan a robbery. You can choose which
Ja.
building you want to rob, which people you take with you and when you do it and so on.
Okay.
And it's a lot of planning. It's not like just a typical point-and-click adventure. It's,
It's more like an economic
yeah,
simulation or
yeah,
something like
like
that.
that.
Okay.
Yeah.
But I'm kind of intrigued. I mean,
I
not
never
for.
played it. I always wanted to, but then I saw all these screens and I'm not sure if I will understand it properly.
Yeah, I mean, not really for our game as a
Yeah.
research, but just as a game. That looked interesting. I just love the style. Also, you don't recognize, okay, is this an old game or is it just an indie game from 2000, well, I don't know, 20
Both.
something. I mean, I kind of like the also the wire, the what's the name? Barbed wire.
Ah, okay.
I guess it's
Yes.
It looks really cool. I like the Great Escape was another, but it's more not like thieving in, but thieving out.
Reminds me of The Escapists or what the name was of
Yeah.
the new games.
Me too, me too. And there were more recommendations. Voxer recommended the first Metal Gear. Which I didn't know. It's like also for NES, but also they seem to do like a smartphone version of it.
That's obviously something we should really research if we can do our game for smartphones too,
Yes.
because people love it when mobile games are made to PC games.
Yeah, totally. But also, do you remember the little Xardas game? Of like spin-off of Gothic, that was
Sure.
I always wanted to play
I heard
that
it's one of the best mobile games
in the world.
back then when there weren't any mobile games,
Yeah.
because it wasn't smartphones, it was really those. They barely had graphical capabilities, it seems.
Yeah, that's true. I mean, it looked amazing, and yeah. Anyway, I put Metal Gear on our list because we got like I think PlayStation 1 Metal Gear.
Let's see if we can play that.
Let's see if we
Maybe with
can
an emulator.
emulate or really do the. Yeah, I mean, we got all the tech to do a PlayStation 1 emulation. All right, I think there was another one. I think there was a third one. This one! What is it? Metropolis.
2400 AD.
Is it Stealth? I'm not sure. Doesn't look like Stealth at all. So, thanks, Yari Kompa and Voxel for the recommendations. We put them on the list. And speaking of the list, of course, we have to prepare the next poll, which game to play next.
Yeah.
And we have to. Didn't I click on it? Huh?
What are you searching?
Oh, I. Ah, fuck it. I wanted to put it.
What are you searching?
I don't want to use this. I wanted to open my I do this. It makes it easy. I want to open our stealth list where all the games that we are going to research is on, and I prepared it wrong. To search, to put a new game on the list, and I wanted to ask you which kind of game we should put on the list. So here's the list. Okay, what would you prefer to? I think of The Occupation. You didn't play, or did you see me playing The
I
Occupation?
don't remember, so probably not.
It's a political game where you're a journalist and you Well, you're a journalist, I think you're some kind of journalist, and you go into a what's the name? Where's the mayor sit? What's Rathaus? The mayor building.
Yeah, the mayor
You
building.
go into the mayor building, but also
Hey, hey, olds.
hey guys. And Vendazil, I...
Hey.
Hey, thanks, by the way, for playing that questionnaire.
Let's answering.
answer the questionnaire. It was so fun watching you. We just recommended it in the stream, and I think I also linked the video. That was awesome. How you transformed it with some ideas also. Yeah, so which we are just deciding which game to play next, and I was just talking about the occupation. So you're going into, I are looking what the Mayo building is really called.
Stop saying Town Hall.
Town Hall.
City Hall.
You also go into a company and to, I don't really know where you are. I think it's a town hall, but also other buildings. You break in, you try to retrieve information, and you also hack into computers, you listen to people. So it's like, it sounds like the perfect information hacking stealth game, but also it was kind of complicated in the way it was made.
Yeah.
Because I also work with time a lot.
But you only gave it 3 of 5.
Yeah. Like I said, it's not a perfect game. It's. I think it's also because it's time-based. I hated that because it, you know, you have 1 hour to do the stuff. Really 1 hour.
Yeah.
And what you got in this time and after that, you question a person with what you thought about them. And if you don't have enough material, your questions are just lame. So if your stealth was bad, you can't really answer questions. So
I
you,
see.
And I kind of... like the approach.
So it's very story based.
Yeah, but it's also a stealth game. A stealth game with story.
Okay, maybe we should play Acid Spy.
Acid Spy.
As a contrapoint to the occupation. So like the both.
I mean, people have to decide. I just wanted to talk about which game we put on the list just as much. Just one game. No. I would let Aragami stay on the list, you know,
sure,
until they got played, you know, until we only put him away if people vote for
okay.
So I mean, we can play Acid Spy.
I mean, you can click on it on the link.
Okay,
it's very simplistic.
Ooh,
but it's okay. I found it's a very fun stealth game actually, but I stopped playing it when there were mandatory wall jumping parts that I just couldn't.
Okay, and Acid, yeah, obviously for the name. Yeah, let's put it on there. Maybe Batman gets voted because nobody knows this game.
Whatever, man.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, that's the plan for next week, and I collected some discussions that came on. That we could do before we play the actual game. You know, like I thought before we play an actual new stealth game, okay, you looked into Styx, I didn't before. I thought we could do some, you know, discuss some topics like how important is the look of the character or perhaps yay or nay. Although we should do this after I played through Thief 3 because I have a strong opinion about that. Or are you indoor or outdoor? I already know the answer, but after playing Shadwen, are you for indoor or outdoor stealthing? Another topic would be, maybe you don't have to answer them, just one topic, okay? Or are stealth games actually puzzle games?
No.
Okay, discussion is over. Thank you for this.
I can give a reason for it.
I would go into how can stealth games be more diverse, because that was one big problem last week with Shadwen, and you can also you played Shadwen through. And also two comments I put out of a very, very large list of a comment person called Dot. Just a point.
On our YouTube video.
On YouTube. Thanks for commenting so much. I just put out, it's really a long text, I just put out two things.
Yeah.
That he just watched and commented, and two of his comments were, one was, the type of guard definitely plays a big role as well. Having the alien from Alien Isolation, having the alien from Alien Isolation makes a completely different kind of stealth experience. From what I've got, you've set your eyes on this type of approach. which doesn't, we don't look at alien, alien isolation, right?
We have neither Shadwin, which we played back then, nor the alien experience in mind, right? I think it's both totally...
Shadwin is more physical based, I would say, and more puzzle based, like he's, like he also said.
Shadwin totally has the element of luring guards away. That's like 80% of what you do.
Yeah.
And we won't have that much. Probably sometimes, but not that much. And yeah. Alien isolation is like you only have one enemy.
Mm-hmm.
And
it's more horror, like
it's that, totally horror.
What's a horror game? Amnesia. It's more like Amnesia, I presume.
I can't actually tell that much about Alien Isolation because I stopped at some point and yeah. Can't say what the game actually is because it got a lot more cinematic sequences than I thought it would have.
Mm-hmm.
And after that, it didn't interest me that much to play further when the alien was like the main thing.
Let's get further into
it
when we maybe play it. And you also wrote another thing. What about a Hitman type stealth game how about a Hitman type stealth game without all the assassination and stuff? The concept of individually planning runs for specific maps with different obstacles seems fun. Maybe there could even be a progress system for character traits in between levels.
This sounds totally more like a puzzle game.
Yeah, I guess.
Planning runs for specific maps.
I mean, it has to be like a puzzle game, or it's like a complete sandbox game, you know.
It's more like what's the game with the girl, the very white,
the one girl.
You remember it? Mirror's Edge.
Oh.
Bit like with specific maps with different obstacles, like. Sounds more like a parkour game than
I thought something. When I read this, or when I read this just now, of stacking. Do you remember that game?
Yeah, by Dubfine.
Yeah. It's like you got matryoshkas, and or the characters in the game are like matryoshkas, and you can stack them or go into them or cover them with your body.
Actually, no. If you go inside, or if you.
I think you go inside because you take over them. Ooh. I don't know. Is it a stealth game?
I don't actually
just
look.
I don't want to look at it right now because I don't want to talk about a speculative game too much. But I have to look into it. But I like the approach. I mean, we also don't have assassination, so maybe it's like our game. Maybe with clothing, with cross-dressing. That would be fun.
Dress as the guys and just walk around for hours.
Yeah, I mean, you do this in Thieves once, right? Dressing?
Yeah, you dress as one of the Hammerites
to
infiltrate them and steal something from them.
Yeah, why not? Getting back to the topic of how can stealth games, especially Shadwin that you played through, be more diverse? What would you say? Because our experience was, okay, it's most of the time the same. Like you said, you mostly want a guard. The guard is in your way, so you allure the guard away. And you do this with physical, with boxes, or by going into bushes and pulling boxes from there. Pulling boxes from up, from above the guard, or from bushes.
Yeah.
And how would you improve to make the game more diverse?
I think would improve it because the game is like one node.
Yeah, okay. Now, you know, there are you students. How would you recommend them to make the game better?
Take something away for a while at least. Like make a level in between where you don't have your grappling hook. Make it interesting from time to time. Change the setting for God's sake, because It was really the straight path from the village or city to the castle.
Yeah.
And even when you came to the castle, there were still village assets and so on, because they didn't have much more assets were probably to use. So they are very nice assets, very good looking assets, but
yeah.
At some point you looked at them for 5 levels and now you look at them for another 5 levels.
Yeah, that's the game.
Yeah, that's the cool part of the game that I didn't play because I didn't kill anybody.
And you learned that killing everybody might be a more fun game approach?
No idea if killing everybody would be more fun, but killing some people would probably make the game a bit more interesting.
Hmm. I've also thought that's the indoor-outdoor question. Maybe to tackle it a little bit, I felt that the level for me, you know, the perfect stealth game for me is also part exploration, so like Thief does it. It's too much. I just look at the animations, so not good. A big part of a good stealth game for me is to explore the landscape I'm put in, or the room I'm put in.
Yeah, sure.
To get to know it, to get the upper hand in this level, because right now I'm like new in there, I don't know anything what's in there, I don't know where my goal is, I don't know how many enemies are there, I don't know how many rooms are there, you know, I know nothing about, but the people in there, they know all about it. So the first thing that I found most interesting is infiltration. To get to know the stuff. And I feel here, the levels, and I think it's because of the grappling hook thing, in those levels you always get, you know, the oversight very quickly.
Sure.
It's not much exploration. And I feel maybe that's what you meant by taking away the grappling hook. By if you are not able to see the whole level at once, mostly, it'd be more interesting.
Would be, depends, because thanks to the gameplay of the game with the little character you have to guide through,
yeah,
it would make the game frustrating if you don't know much.
Assuming she's not there, okay, because I think it's a bad idea.
I just think it, totally.
Yeah, but okay, there's also Sekiro, you know, from software. And there you got a grappling hook too. It's also third person. It's also very oversight, but still the walls sometimes are so high you can't get over them, so you have to go through doors or move above roofs.
Yeah.
So you still need to have the oversight by exploring the area, you know? So I would say it's possible, you know, the game is still possible.
Definitely.
Without the little girl.
Sure, definitely.
So that's why I don't
change the game totally, like make the enemies more diverse.
Yeah.
Right now it's all guards. Even, I mean, there are guards without armor and guards with heavy armor. That's the only difference. So you don't even have animals that react to something. You don't have
dogs. Would be amazing. I think they're in stealth games. They can add really some interesting stuff. You know, they can't get everywhere. They can't shoot you from afar,
they can smell you.
Or they can at least hear you, run to you, bark at a position at a certain position where you are. Maybe follow you. I can't remember where I last had dogs in a stealth game. Maybe it was Batman. I can't remember, but there is a stealth game where you got dogs, and that was really interesting.
I'm not sure if Shadman would have benefited from any other enemy types. If you get spotted, it doesn't make a difference who spots you and how. You have to rewind the time.
Yeah.
That's all.
So, but you played it through. Why? Because
it was like one note, it was a flow. At some point you just, okay, I can do this level 2 because I made the level before that, and now I want to at least to have the final achievement.
So you did it for achievement?
I did it because, yeah, of course for completion, because I don't think I made it for the story, because
the in-between lines of the characters weren't that interesting, and the end wasn't interesting.
No.
Like, you didn't even know why you are hunting the king and why you are trying to assist
him. Isn't it? Would have profited from story.
Sure.
About the world.
But definitely.
Okay, anything more to add for diversity? Like, as a learning that we want to put in our own game, maybe? Like, enemy types, exploration was a thing, and also...
level design.
Yeah, level design, assets.
Assets.
And stripping away the player of one of their powers.
Maybe. Like, pacing, like, not... The player does all the time the same thing all the time, but at some point he or she has to like just look around instead of stealth, or just, I don't know, run away, or
yeah,
or the enemies are suddenly not you can't kill them because they're like undead or something, which was what Thief did very early.
Mm-hmm.
And instantly changed the gaming experience.
Oh yeah, that was something that I really I just told you, but I want to repeat it, that when I played Thief for the first time, I think it starts with humans as enemies, and the second level there are zombies, and I was so frightful. I didn't know what to do with the stealth I learned in the first part until you told me, hey, it's zombies, but you have to treat them like humans. They also don't see you in the dark. And I, because of the enemy type, I didn't believe that.
Mm.
Maybe you played the game more, you approached them, you tried this, but maybe I was so in fear because of this enemy type, because also you can't kill it, knock it out.
Yeah.
And even if you kill them with your sword, they get up soon after that. It adds so much just because of the zombies.
The interesting thing is too that you can kill any character with your sword.
Yeah.
In Thief 1. While in Thief 2...
Even the zombies?
Yeah, well, you can kill them. You can hit them so much until they go down again, but you should run away then, because if you stay too long in their near...
Yeah, they get up again.
They get up again. But
yeah, so you can't kill them.
You can't kill them, but then they're on the ground. They are not standing up until you approach them again. Yes, believe me.
Okay, so much stuff I don't know about the zombies.
Yeah.
I think we have to have a feature for them.
Sure. And in Thief 2, they have those robots.
Yeah.
And you can still kill them with your sword, because it's just damage.
Mm-hmm.
But the sword suddenly makes a lot of crazy sound, because it makes this big metal clank.
Yeah, yeah.
If you hit them. So it's the new like element, even though it's all the elements introduced before, but twisted a little bit. And these things are making Thief so diverse.
Yeah. So different enemy types is a thing we should
different approach. Enemy types, different like reactions to your actions from these enemy types.
Yeah. Okay, so much for diversity. How we would hope to make,
not speaking of the
diverse.
Other diversity with non-white people and so on.
Yeah, how to make the gameplay
yeah,
not boring. Okay. Right. Not like a bird. Not flatten the curve of enthusiasm. Okay.
That's the new approach.
All right. So today's game is Sticks. Why there? So let's play Sticks.
Did you test it?
No.
Okay.
I just hope it works, because it's not that old. I love the name Master of Shadows.
Super generic.
It's super generic. But yeah, I think we just brainstormed names, and it's always like Shadows, Dark, Thief, stuff. We have to have it as well. So, Sticks, you already played it, but you didn't went that far, right?
Yeah, as usual. Somehow that's an reoccurring element here.
But do you remember what stopped you with the game?
You're an assassin. I'm not that much into... killing so much people. I think at some point, I mean, I think I could not kill people, but at some point the levels got so big and hard, and without killing anyone would be possible. But I don't actually know if there's a no kill approach to it.
Yeah.
So let's try it again.
Okay. Easy. Difficult is suitable for casual play. Enemies take longer to detect you and damage the infliction.
It's lame.
Hard. I just want to read, but they change. Difficulty is suitable for an experienced player. Goblin, yeah. Difficulty is suitable for a player who likes a realistic challenge. A realistic challenge. Like if you would be an assassin.
The interesting thing also is that Styx is actually a character from another game that I also have, and that usually at some point for my birthday gifted me the soundtrack because I liked it a lot, of Orcs and Men, I think was the name.
Oh.
And Styx Atrium is, of Akinash. Like you play with an orc. World shut inside another. And this is what humans do when they don't understand a thing.
They build walls around it. They put locks on the doors, and they put soldiers in front of those doors. The bigger the secret, the bigger the lock. And the craziest are those who want to pick it. May my ancestors forgive me. I'm one of those, to my misfortune. This noise, these voices, I can't stand it. Amber,
that
damn. I think it's total over character, like too much character for the character.
That was also, I want to talk to you after the intro.
All the thoughts of those who wanted to taste the forbidden sap. Humans, elves. All their private little chatter is mixed up
in enemies.
Disgusting soup. A flood of ideas constantly flowing into my head for all these years. It took so long for me to find this place. With each step, I heard my voice a little less, and all the others a little more. I'm so tired. It's time to finish it. While I can still recognize my own thoughts.
It's like Cyberpunk.
The heart of the cyanide studios. It's why I'm here. From
that,
are they
at
French?
Least, I am sure is my own desire.
Just a guess, okay.
Take possession of this source of infinite power, but also misfortune. It's time to move to the first phase of the plan.
Paris,
like I said. Ha. I just thought now. By looking at it that it's French.
Call of Cthulhu.
That's what he did before.
Wake up. Answer when Lord Barnum speaks to you. Who are you? Speak.
My name is Styx.
There's a surprise. The elves give names to their monsters.
Where do you come from? I've never seen anything that looks like you.
I am one of a kind.
It's the elves who created it, Father. That's obvious.
Like,
they pulled this runt out
like
of their
the
sticky
style.
Larvae, and they sent it here to spy
like,
on
like
us.
Large hands and stuff, and nose.
I mean,
it is the elves who sent you.
The steampunk time.
Why are you here?
With the birded guys.
Elves. Yeah, too. They're too.
If you only knew. They don't need spies to find out what's going on in this accursed tower.
So, you're working for them. What did you come here for?
I came for the heart of the tree, of course.
I knew it. Those degenerates want to retake the tree and keep their precious amber for themselves. Father, we must bring them to heel while we still have time.
Enough, Aaron. I secured this alliance with the elves, and I intend to respect it. For the moment, we need the elves. You know it very well.
Rubbish.
Oh, yes, you do need the elves. How many of you poor little humans died the last time you tried to extract amber by yourselves, huh? How many? Hundreds? Oh yes, you do need the elves. But they don't need you. How long do you think you can lock them up in their own world? The amber is theirs. The tree is theirs. The heart of the tree.
Do you see elves
theirs.
In this game?
And I intend to get my hands on it and
and I take it away from you. They're dying don't remember to get their tree back, eh? Of orcs and
but they
humans.
Won't do a thing. We have an agreement. An agreement? Man. We don't sign agreements with people elves. Who have amber in their veins. You're out of your depth, Mr. Governor.
Oh, you've got some nerve. I'm sure you've never even seen the heart of the tree. Oh, but I have seen it.
What?
Since I've been holed up in the bowels of the atrium, I can see it night and day, even in my dreams. And every day I say to myself, hey, Rakash, the heart of the tree is over there. Almost within reach.
Who's talking to
him? Your life, you're gonna find so. Some way to steal it.
But he said he hears voices the closer he gets.
Yeah, I don't know.
Okay, you wanted to talk about
the character is from a game called Of Orcs and Men.
Yeah.
Where you play a big fat orc, like super muscular, and this guy. As like they always play together and you have these tactical combat.
The character controller feels kind of nice.
And the character is itself a goblin, and there are a lot of goblins in this world, but they don't speak. You're the only speaking goblin.
Mm-hmm.
And his background story, which you unravel in Of Orcs and Men, is that he actually is an orc who is also a scientist who made himself a goblin.
Doesn't look like
and
a scientist.
Created all the goblins, but didn't remember. And this was such a stupid story.
Okay.
Very dark, isn't it?
The game? Ah, yes, you're right. Let me fix that in OBS. Desktop. Wait. Filters. Color correction?
Yeah.
Maybe a bit more. I think it's very dark. I think it already is. Okay. Yeah, I think it's maybe a bit too much. But
it's too much.
It's a bit too
I think Gamma is not the right choice. At least not alone.
Okay.
I would also add contrast.
Hmm.
And brightness.
I think it's not too much. Nine, not reset. Yeah, but I think it's okay. At least you see the graphics better.
If you think so.
Yeah, I think so. Okay. All right. So we wanted to talk about the character, and you said he's a bit much.
Yeah, he's very character-y. Like. You're a goblin, one of a kind. You also hear voices. You're like kind of sick.
Yeah.
And you have like a motivation that is totally alien to you because, as a player.
Yeah.
Because you don't know anything about this tree. Like in Thief, you start with the main purpose, I want money.
Yeah.
And
I mean, at least here you want to get out. I think that's a good motivation.
Okay, you start with you want to get out somehow.
I don't like that you got like 6 meters to fulfill this. I am not a fan of that.
I'm sorry.
Just saying, okay. It's very consoling, you know, with the Sprungweite.
Jump length.
Yeah, no, I mean the Abstand. You know, like the distance, it's like exactly in a grid, but I kind of like that. It's.
Did you see the dagger that Duncan
It always found? Depends for me if it comes from. Naturally or if you just notice it
yeah,
too
well,
much.
Yeah, well, don't get excited. We'll play for it with dice tonight. In the meantime, keep your hands off. Okay. I'll wait till tonight.
I really want to know if the artist who does maybe like the art style for the characters is also at Arcane Studios. They look so close to Dishonored. What did you say from when is the game?
From when?
Yeah.
I didn't say anything.
I like that he gets lit. You know, his arm gets lit. I think when he's near this ember stuff. It's kind of fun.
This is from 2014. It's as old as Tri.
What did you say?
The game is from 2014.
Mm-hmm. Okay. And it also has, it was kind of successful. It has exactly. Also
exactly as old as Tri. It was released on October the 7th.
Wow. Okay.
Do it right.
Yeah, thanks for the input. Favorite. So glad.
Yeah, that's very console.
Maybe you should have played it with controller. Be careful. Unable to defend yourself, you must avoid being detected until you find your dagger. That's what he's saying all the time. Thanks. Wow, fucking, I didn't listen.
You are the special.
So it's Shadow-based, right? Oh, that was my question. Does it just call itself Master of Shadows, or is it also a shadow?
I'm actually not sure.
To move covertly, crouching will soften your footsteps. This is the best way to surprise you or evade your enemies. However, be careful where you put your feet as enemies react if you knock into objects. Okay. Okay, you're sleeping anyway. Great. Good job.
Yeah, well, you're crouching.
I know.
Good job, right?
Navigate in the dark. You are the master of shadows. The more you stay in the dark, the less chance there is of being detective. Ah, your tattoo, that's what it is for. Will light up to indicate when you are less likely to be seen. Ah, so it's light up when it's dark.
Right.
So it doesn't have any to do with the app. Yeah. But it's cool. I like that it's a tattoo because the game is always a bit. It's an interface.
Yeah, sure. But you can. I mean,
it's a HUD, okay? And this is like.
Sure, I understand, but this is a third person game. I think in first person, you could do like. Look at your hand and have a tattoo, but that doesn't make much sense.
You indicate also extinguish torches to create darkness. Yeah, in Cyberpunk, they did like add what's the name? No, nicht Rosette, Vignette. A vignette?
Yeah.
Vignette. Vignette.
Yeah, vignette, okay.
A vignette to it. So you can see in first person if you are crouching.
Yeah, and I hated that because it made the game darker and sometimes I couldn't see less because of that. To the
shadows. Ooh, look at this. Where it doesn't make too much noise. Avoid running. Farting. Yeah. Farting? Did you say farting?
Avoid running and farting.
Or did I just make that up? I don't know. I have to look where I can save. Quick save. Wait. Controls. Okay.
Quick save is forbidden. F5.
F5?
Yeah.
But it was grayed out.
Because probably you can't change that theme.
F5. Game save. Yeah. What do I open it?
You can't. I think there's a switch somewhere on the left.
Maybe I have to get to these guys.
No. Pick. I think there's a switch on the left.
Ah, oh God. Okay. The stick could have been a bit thicker. Because everything is like just very thick. No, not that.
It's crazy because it looks like, oh, it's right around the corner, so the thing, but it's like at the end of the game.
Yeah, okay. It's so big that it seems
to be close. If you even tell that. Way to go.
Even says a long way to go. Oh, those are the elves. Which that two-faced governor Baron has had
closed off tamper-proof lock, and he keeps the only key in his apartments. And as if that wasn't bad enough, the whole area is crawling with elves. I'm gonna have to go down into the prisons and free my
okay. They look interesting.
Friend. He knows how to deal with an elf. So, if I'm gonna survive in this town, I'm gonna need somewhere safe to get organized, as well as a map of the atrium. Well, I'll get nothing done standing around here. Get my dagger, and it's off.
I should definitely go now.
I mean, although I agree with what you said, that he's a bit too much, like, there's so much backstory.
Gotta be sneaky here. If I stay under there, I won't be seen.
Also, I don't like his,
voice?
No, I like his voice very much, but the self-talking is something I don't like.
The monologues.
The monologues, it's... I'm not a fan of that. Because sometimes I try to think about what I'm doing and the character speaks over what I want to think about the game or too. So that's okay.
Ah, there's my dagger. I was afraid that I lost you, my beauty.
Why didn't you just take a lot of the other ones?
Maps of the zone stuck up here. Let's see. We got maps of the area. More than that to get what I want.
Okay. Does he come?
Three.
I must have been mistaken.
What?
Can you go to the door?
Ooh, that's cool. Yeah, but what I wanted to say is I like the setting very much and that you are like this goblin assassin. It's kind of cool to walk.
It looks cool.
It feels good. Okay, so there's no lockpicking minigame.
Sure.
It's just your weight. I know.
I think I like that best. I hate lockpicking minigames, usually.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay. So you don't want to have a lockpicking minigame in our game?
Probably not. Only if it really adds to the game.
Because I mean, it's fun that most stealth games have their own unique lockpicking game. You know? Oh, I thought it's a plank that. Oh.
No, it's not.
Yeah.
That's what I always hated about the game.
What?
You have to press a button to continue.
Hmm.
After quick loading.
Yeah, because if you are like in a scene, like here, if there's a character like right coming in, he would detect you. So it makes sense that you...
It doesn't make sense because you know you just quick loaded and they just showed the loading screen instead of like the scene. So, okay, it doesn't make a difference.
Hmm. Heh?
I think that's not the way to go.
What? The fuck? Yeah, because it was open, you know, there was the barricade, it was open, so I thought, okay, they want me to go through there and look maybe down, and there was this route, and it looked like I could jump.
Yeah, I understand.
I must really say, I hate it when games, you know, they open a wide space where you can actually only use a very small path, and everything looks like you can jump there. But you can't. It happened to me in Jedi Fallen Order a lot because everything looked solid, like you could go there, but those things. They're very, subtle, yeah, which is kind of cool because I also don't like when it's too gamey. So it's kind of cool that it's very subtle, but in a way...
It's missing those white marks.
Yeah.
Everywhere. Hackenstein says, I like in lockpicking minigames if they are well made. Well, that's a given, right? You want your lockpicking minigame well made because otherwise it's atrocious either way. But my problem often is that they are often very repetitive. You do them too often, and then it doesn't matter if it's well made or not because it's annoying. Like at some point, I found the hacking in Cyberpunk annoying.
What, kill?
Because it didn't become much more diverse later on.
I can't leave this stiff lying around. That would be messy. I could have also not killed him, right? On to the cupboard!
Yeah, you could. I think I played really without killing anyone.
Okay, well.
Somehow I dragged the fun out of the games by doing that.
Wait, you think killing is dragging the fun out of games?
Not trying to not kill everybody, that's often dragging the fun out of the game.
Yeah.
I guess.
Yeah, I mean, I agree. I also often play in this way. Wait, I have to read. When the guards attack you in melee combat, you're locked in and must repel their attacks. Parry their attacks at the proper timing. Ugh. Kill them when they are off balance. So, where are they?
I like it when lockpicking really is the time, because it adds to the suspension. It adds to the excitement, and it isn't annoying. And you can stop it anytime.
Ah. Yeah. Fuck. Fuck. I thought I can do.
You need to get physically better at them.
What the fuck? The fighting is so weird. I can't.
I remember that.
I can't jump right or left. I can roll. Okay. If I slash the enemy, nothing happens. Okay. I have to slash him in the right moment.
You are stealth character. The fighting is not like directly killing them. You have to be very precise.
Wow. I really hate fighting right now.
Wait, I just want to do it. Yeah. You need to get physically better at the minigames. I'm not sure which game really did this, but maybe it was Oblivion, Skyrim or Fallout 3. I remember the Skyrim minigame, and at some point it was, okay, it's... If you are bad at lockpicking because of the skill level, you just have to find this little pixel, this super correct angle of the lockpick, and then you can do it even if you are bad at it. And that's what I tried a lot of times, and dragged always the fun out of it.
I just put on our list lockpicking minigame. Because I think that's a topic of their own picking.
Sure.
I also remember Kingdom Come Deliverance.
Oh.
It had a prominent lockpicking game, which you can't really, I think, which was okay on PC, but unbeatable with controller. People really, really, really got stuck on it. And I don't remember how it was. I think a bit to Skyrim. I think you had to find the sweet spot. And I can't remember why. Or was it only beatable with controller? Because it was like humming, you know?
I remembered it was awkward to play because it felt like a glitch.
Yeah.
Like this little tumbler or whatever it was that would glitch around, and you had to keep it somehow inside the circle you are rotating.
It was also unlogical. I don't know. It was like a mini game made up, but it didn't really fit the thing. Do you want to read it?
Yeah, that's it. I like that. It makes me feel like I actually learned how to pick lock. I always level lock picking if it's in the game.
The Skyrim.
Yeah, well, me too, because that's always giving you the good treasures, but usually I'm not a fan of the minigames.
Oh.
And I'm not really keen on learning how to actually pick lock. I want to be a cool thief who can do it on its own instead of me having to do it with my mouse and keyboard. I don't know. Just me.
Yeah. I must say, but I don't like if games only allow certain actions, like using my sword if I'm in fighting mode.
Yeah.
Because right now I would love to use my sword, my stab, dagger, stab, whatever, to check the timing, you know, because I feel it's a little bit off. I click and it's like a second later he's slashing.
Yeah.
And I would love to look at that, but I can't because he's only using the dagger if I'm in fighting mode. Yeah. I don't understand games that don't allow me using those.
I have to fight him. Gotta find the best moment.
I think it gets bigger, the icon, and then you get him. Yeah, well, now you can kill him.
He's also, I mean, games these days, they heavily celebrate the killing. And he's like, that's it. Nothing more.
Sure, it's like Tuesday for him.
Let's save that.
Also, a thing with mini games with lockpicking for me very often is it drags me, it stops the game for me. It's like, oh shit, now I have to make this other game inside the game and then I can't see what's around me. And a big part of stealth games for me is that you can always get spotted by an enemy, right?
Mm-hmm.
Anytime. So the just the timer is enough for me to be excited because, well, there could be an enemy coming around the corner, and that while I'm standing at the door, in the worst case, in the light.
Yeah.
And with those mini games, they suddenly change the game. They change the pacing to the stupid mini game. And the stealth part is suddenly not important anymore.
Can you say the last thing again?
No. What?
Okay, I continue. When guards are nearby, I can be risky to extinguish a torch yourself. In such cases, you can pick up balls of sand and throw them onto the torches in order to... Okay.
I'm just saying, yeah, I want to be in the game as much as constant as possible.
Yeah.
And mini games usually put you out of that. I really liked the hacking mini game in Neon Struct because it was just a funny breakout clone, and it was like a little bit like a parody. And the game would wouldn't stop. But yeah, the part, I mean, hacking is always a little bit different because there you really have to concentrate and you can't look left and right.
I really love what they did here. It's really a fun combination of so many elements. Also that you can already see that you would be go like
this. I think it's where where we ask stealth games, basically puzzle games. Because this is the case, right? You get like elements like sand to extinguish the torches. But the sand is only on some certain spots in the level.
I think it depends on the level design. If they make an open level design and give you more possibilities, like three possibilities, it feels more sandboxy. But if they don't do that,
I'm not sure if the amount of possibilities makes more sandboxy. It's more like giving you the possibility anytime to change your approach.
What did you say? Sorry,
okay, it's okay. For me, a game is sandboxy if you can change your approach anytime, not directed by the game directly. Okay?
Yeah.
The thing is that you have a sand bag and the torches at some point, and those parts where you can climb and not climb anywhere, this makes it instantly more puzzle game for me.
Yeah.
Like the cupboards where you can hide. Instead of you can hide anytime, you now have certain points where you have to hide.
Mm-hmm.
Probably.
it reminds me very much of can I throw there? No, no target. Oh. I thought I could use it here to jump here, but I can't throw it up there, so.
You can't climb on those barrels, right?
I can, but he's seeing me, yeah. I think. Not seeing my glowy tattoo. Oh, this guy left on the left saw me. I don't know, but when I climbed up there, or I'm too much in the light, I guess.
Some lookups there.
Yeah.
Hmm.
What?
Oh, you were totally in the light.
Run.
I find it weird that he is just standing there. He should always be pressed to the wall in my mind.
Hmm.
I don't find that necessary, but okay, that's what games nowadays do. I mean, this is a very small team with a probably a bit too big game for the team size.
F9. That's
for loading.
Okay.
So they probably did have to cut some features like on wall. He is hidden in the shadows. Always.
Yeah.
Doesn't matter if he presses on the wall or
not. I'm always, yeah, like I said, I'm waiting for the game to start, but
if the shadow's in the middle of the room, he would be hidden there too. So you can't actually use pressing on wall as indicator because sometimes it wouldn't fit. Or you would have fit on the floor.
Yeah. Okay, save.
Does it have several quick save?
I hope so. I don't know.
Oh, autosave.
Ah, I thought I can get up here, but I can't. Hmm.
Someone there.
What? That guy saw me? Come on. I just
he noticed
wanted to check to get up here, but I don't know how. It doesn't matter.
Might be that you come back. But still.
Shit, more guards. Stay hidden behind this barrel and should be fine.
Hold, take cover.
Ah, so that's what you wanted to. Hell.
Ah, he actually does it.
Yeah.
You have to press the right button, right mouse button.
So am I taking cover? It doesn't feel that different. You know, it should have been.
See? The Hackenstein was right. Hackenstein.
Nice that this button triggered them going further. Okay. Now what? Ah, cover.
You're already dead. You know
what?
That.
Yeah, whatever.
That's great AI.
Oh no. But I pressed the button the whole time. Mm-hmm. Sucks.
You hate it too.
I think I understand. I'm still thinking that I did it because sometimes you save in positions where enemies might come if they just start
the game. Yeah, change how those enemies react. I think it drags the game out too much and destroys the flow. At least
I think that's the problem. He doesn't go around the corner.
Yeah, you have to press E.
What, I have to press E? Ah, pass. Okay.
Hmm. Yeah, it's very controller. I think you should use that.
Bit.
Now you can go there and pass on to that, I think.
No. What?
Or can you?
Not really. If you pass in the same on the same object around the corner, not to the next, which would be cool, but you don't. Okay, unlock skills. Skill points allow you to learn new skills when you're in your hideout. You gain them by completing missions, okay, but also by completing secondary objectives and unlocking insignia.
I think this was one of the reasons why I didn't play it further, because there was so much stuff in the level, like some extras, and some of them you could only get if you really do, I think, killing.
Okay.
And with, like, some...
And you just didn't accept to play Assassin.
I don't know, it was so much, suddenly.
Yeah. That's what I remember.
Yeah. He looks so gamey with all the
bells.
Like, he gets 5 bells around his arms, 6 around his legs. I mean, sometimes it looks like game school students would design a character. He looks amazing, okay? Don't get me wrong, but it's, I don't know.
That's what I meant with he's such a character, like,
yeah,
in the character school of characters, he was the top character of all characters.
It's like, it feels a bit like 90s game design character. I feel today game characters look... Ooh, they have little lamps on their head. Yeah. What?
Gets hot.
Ah!
Gets hot.
You can't even wait behind them and talk and have a chat. It's annoying.
That's not stuff. That's not the stuff I remember. I'd really like to study. Yeah, I think you can press on the wall. Closely, it would be
fascinating. Probably. Quite so, my dear colleague. I'd be my willing dear to colleague. Read an edition of the Encyclopedia of Mycology for the right to dissect one. You're telling me? Hey, one doesn't dissect the embryos of one's political allies, I suppose. Okay. How do I pass? Not passing?
You can't. This. Probably because there's a height difference.
Oh, there's the boss enemy! No, it's the... Ah, it's the elf!
I don't know.
Let's throw balls of sand. Why? Why? What? Ah, man.
I don't think you need to. Ah.
But I do. That's what I like about their level design. It's like... They really seem to design, have design. Just to make sure the way is clear. They seem to spend too much time on talking. No, they, you know, they did this open thing that you can't go there, but you see what's next, or you see possible other paths to go.
Okay. I mean, it opens up a lot later on.
Damn, he said something, but
not necessary. You have to peek through the keyhole.
Ah.
I'm sure he will repeat that line at some point.
Okay.
What do we have to do?
No, I stood there to open the door, but it just opens there. I mean, I see there are the hinges, but I would have put the trigger here as well. No? I don't know. It's like...
Makes no sense.
Unlock. Anyway, I like level designs where level designers also open up the world that you walk through by showing more stuff that is outside, that you get to later, that you never will get to, but just can see. I gotta get some now. My head is gonna explode. He feels a bit too actiony. I would love him to be more broody, you know. He's gonna explode. He looks like a action, you know, this action hero type. Fuck yeah! Okay, not totally, but a little bit.
Okay. Well, he's an assassin.
I thought he's a scientist.
Okay. He's like a magician scientist.
Scientist, assassin, magician. Okay, what? Whoa. Thanks to the Amber, you can create and control a clone. You can use a clone to enter areas that are inaccessible or to distract your enemies. Once a clone has served its purpose, you can destroy it and recover Amber. The life of a clone is short. Once their limit is reached, they die by themselves. Okay. Why do I use clones? For what?
You will see.
Okay. There's a photo there. Wasn't there something? Ah, here.
Yeah, like those coins everywhere.
No, I'm collecting the ones.
Too many.
Oh, can I use it? No, I can't.
Does it make the player happy?
By the way, if you want, we can also change. I just want to get a feel for the character controller.
Sure, so, why not?
Change? Okay.
I think I also voted for it, and now I see the clone mechanic.
The clown mechanic. He switches into a clown and makes...
And amuses the others, and they just let him go.
Okay, and now I have to get controls.
You got them? Or I should tell you how to use. No, right click at the wall is...
Yeah, I think I got them.
And F is doing the roll.
Yeah. F.
Yeah.
That's strange. Because you can't press D and F.
Yeah, it's a weird, weird choice.
So, I have to get to this mechanism. How do I do it?
Ah, you can get through those thin.
Yeah.
Well, one and choice. I'll need some help.
Yeah. Well, he was like barfing. Yeah. Okay. And now? And two is using. No, E interact. Clone interaction. Clones that you create can interact with most of the elements of their environment. In particular, you might pass under gates, activate levels, open doors, hide, and more.
You.
Okay.
Go.
If you're not collecting them, you're missing the amber, right? You have to recollect them.
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm not sure.
Or are they floating back to you?
They have a lifetime, so they are not always.
Okay.
The conveniently
placed
little air ducts.
Yeah, and it... you know that. You have to catch me here. I don't see him anymore. Where did he go?
Ah, probably just a rat. Let's go.
Did you say?
I want to know what happens if I wait. Must have been the wind. The dark spirits, like they said in Shadwin all the time. Okay, is he back now?
It would have been fun if they would have, you know, overused the dark spirits, but also talked a little bit about their... What is the other glow of English?
Superstition.
Superstition, you know, like made a bit more lore around the superstition thing.
Yeah, that was fun, but really not enough.
The coin!
Yeah! Orgasm.
Although I must say I like collectibles, okay? I mean, I don't know if I like them in stealth games, but I definitely like them in Mario games. You know, Mario games, especially the modern ones, they, you know, you can reuse the levels like 10 times only to get players to collect different kind of collectibles.
But the psychology behind that is really interesting because it's really just a number that goes up.
Yeah. No, I think it's not just a number that goes up, but also, okay, you looked everywhere, you understood the game.
Yeah.
You found our... Ooh. We found our hidden spaces. You are smart. You did also, you know, you found everything that we hid in the game.
Yeah.
And it's, I like that.
Oh, I have to go to the back end.
So I think I would definitely love if we had some collectibles, not stupid collectibles, you know, that add something to the game.
Oi, what's going on there?
Oi.
That add something to the game, or I also liked, like in... Like the Black Pants game, you know, where you could find cassettes. And then you found new cassettes, you got new songs.
I can't use my amber vision. Detective mode.
Oh, but he's reloading amber. I thought you must have you have to drink it.
Yeah, sure. I have to because.
But it was reloading.
Yeah, sure, but I think that's a maximum. I'm not sure anymore.
Yeah, I guess if you get a new what?
You can hide.
Hey, he's so big, like it.
He's sleeping the eye.
But to me, it feels more playful than Shadwin.
Yeah, sure, definitely. Shadwin has a lot less options what you can do in the game.
I think that's with stealth games because you can't do a lot actively, especially here. You can't really kill people, or you have to fight them in a different way.
He doesn't see me. Okay, shadows are not that useful.
Or did you step out of the shadow?
No, I did.
Also, you can use your sand to throw it, right?
Yeah, sure. You never know if there is a sand shortage later.
I don't know when to refill it. I haven't seen a sack.
There are coming bags. Okay, here's an amber. Wild.
I wonder if you can max it out with that, or
I don't remember.
I think with the wheel you can change the stuff you're using, and with Q you're using it, so you can maybe drink it. I don't know. Save and try. With Q, and with the mouse wheel you.
Okay.
What is that mouse?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, because with the vision, it did reload automatically. So I wondered why you would even need the wild.
I think for the clones. Like, you can later do more clones.
Mm-hmm. I feel they see you too early. Even you don't see them. Oh, they are throwing. That's cool.
Ouch.
Throw a ball of sand at them.
No, yeah, the torches. Okay, let's check. Feels a bit like the Hammerites. Then in Thief 3.
You mean the atmosphere of the game?
Yeah, and the characters and the anyway. And then
I wonder if he wakes up if you break open the door.
I don't think so.
Okay.
Oops. Bro, I have enough amber.
Yeah, 2 of 2.
I thought I heard something.
But they're not really reacting to the sand throws, right?
Like you said, I thought I heard something.
Yeah. I think I saw something over there. Yeah.
You got right. So when you block once, it's successful, and then you can kill them. Okay.
And this kind of fighting is totally useless if there are more than one enemy.
Yeah. Yeah, but that's a good idea.
Because you don't want.
Because one would be annoying to not kill them. It's good that you have the possibility.
Right, and you would be the total super killer if you could fight two enemies at once, yeah. And then it's not a stealth game anymore. Okay. How can I get...
Can you jump there? Jump up there without being seen?
I think I have to take another route.
Can you use your clones to lure them away and then let the clone be killed?
Oh no. What's this? Oh. Okay, where am I? I mean, the level design right now really lets you experiment a bit.
I wonder how big the levels are, or if they're linear. I mean, you got the map, right? Can you press M or something? Okay.
Okay. Alex found and red. What? This is a map. It's not a map.
Ah, there. Okay. Where are you?
I don't know.
Also, the whole game.
Where are you? Who knows?
I mean, this must be the distillery, right? It looks like the part with the stairs up.
Sure, and I think.
Yeah. Okay, so the level is not as big and confusing as I would have thought it to be.
It gets there later.
Yeah.
It gets there.
You can't hide in the basket. It's tired of me.
Doing nothing.
He's not killing
us? Yeah, they are. Innocence, and they actually don't get the guards. Maybe later on.
Yeah.
It looks like the tourist. Looks like he's gone. Okay. There probably goes my stealth card. I'm just looking up.
Yeah, do that. I mean, you're not... Or you're planning on playing it through then.
Yeah,
but I also did already. Yeah, I fucked up in the beginning, so... In the style you would have preferred. I must say, this kind of small shafts that you can go through, it's like one of my favorite in stealth games. You know, that you find paths, not that obvious, okay, but that you find paths that they don't find. It can be like below the ceiling that you can climb there, or above cupboards, or like below the ground, that there's like a secret tunnel system where you could go. Like in Batman, they also do this a lot.
Yeah.
Like with vending shafts, where he's really taking extra animation to rip out.
The fun is, of course, that you use a way nobody else can use and still inside the level.
Yeah, true. And you can also infiltrate a level, get to know it better. Like, you can explore a level without getting seen, but you're not in the place that you would later go.
Yeah.
It's like a sneak peek, literally.
I want to towards the hideout.
Yeah, they're really a bit like the Hammerites, like with their own...
Yeah, that's what I mean.
With their look and their own slogans. A muffled kill. Okay.
Takes longer. Oh, look!
What?
Secret way. Oh, it's good. I think so too. Okay, I killed someone.
But the game will stay in this this setting, right?
Yeah, I don't think it will change. I mean, you could try to find some screenshots from later on.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't remember having others.
But I somehow think they, with their kind of level design, they will achieve the game to be not like Shadwind, that you get bored by it. Because I think they do more can do more with level design.
I actually don't know really. It actually just throws so much at me already, like all these shafts, all these climbing opportunities, all this crouching under tables. It's like I feel, it feels like this is the whole game already, even though it's like the first mission. Okay, what are they doing?
Yeah, sure. So it's either only changing with good level design or new enemy types. I don't know.
I'm running now. But suddenly I can't run forward.
Yeah, they said that when you're in the fight, you can't
get
out of the mode. You stick to
that's
it.
Strange, but I understand the decision. They really want to be fighting very important.
But it's really fun how you recognize French games. It's a bit like
Eurojank.
No, absolutely not. I mean, rather the church thing, you know, the holy thing. It reminds me a bit of Plague Tale. Just the atmosphere, the kind of characters, doing something with Catholic church thingy. The characters, you know, the type of.
Where can I hit him?
There's no cupboard.
And he's going away.
You can use sand, throw it there. This is a joke. It's in bad. If this is a joke, it's in bad taste. Understood. I mean, this is well hidden below the desk. Didn't see it right away. I think for me, the most fun part would, as level designer, the most fun part would be to create those little paths for the player, not to recognize at first, but to, you know, to really find by close exploration.
Yeah, especially when they're optional, when you don't have to use.
Sure, that as well. Maybe some optional, maybe some that you have to use and have to find. There are so many characters already in there.
What am I doing? Is this some confession booth?
Yeah, mushrooms.
Okay, we could now search for these 7 other coins before leaving.
Shit. I just touched something to drink. Stuck. This is impossible. There's got to be a way.
What I like is the sense of height. It's a little bit more than in Shadwell. Okay, can I jump? No.
Grill. Stuck. This is impossible. There's got to be a way.
Tell me the way. Okay.
Hey, Sticks. Over here. What's that? Somebody there? It's Ozcan. I'll open the passage for you. Hurry up inside. Huh? Ozcan? Oh, my head. Yeah, I know that name. Ozcan. Yes, you can trust him. Anyway, you don't have a choice.
About time, Sticks. I've been waiting for ages. I was beginning to wonder if Barryman and his gang hadn't done you in.
There was a slight hitch. Well, I think so. Ah, my head feels like a wagon's gone through it. Well, we'll take care of that later. What are you doing here?
Well, I'm here to tell you that I found a hideout, like you asked me to.
I asked you? Yeah, of course I asked you.
Damn this headache.
Who is he talking to?
I can't remember what I did even yesterday.
I think the character totally reminds me of
I'm off to the hideout then. You'll tell me the way.
Ask for talents.
All you have to do is follow the marks I made here and
why?
There.
You'll see the goblin
this
character.
Is my personal
the, also from the animations because it's hand mark. Animated.
Ah, from their goblins.
One of my hiding places is near. You can who's go this? Inside. There's one close
Ogden.
By with
Ogden.
Happens, a list of other hiding places. You'll see. I often put some useful stuff inside. Thanks.
He's like I'm my off.
Why is he your buddy?
Acquaintance.
You'll have to pick up the sewer pry bar in another hiding place. Oh yeah, one thing I didn't tell you. The hideout is in the sewers. But you know how it is. The more it smells like shit,
they do this
the quieter it is.
With the head, I don't even see that often, that they animate the head like this. I don't
sorry
know, it's
to
kind
you,
of cool.
But with your looks, it's best not to take risks. And anyway, the royal suite was already taken. In short, go on ahead. Pick up the pry bar and open the entrance to the sewers. I'll see you at the hideout.
He didn't really remember him.
Well,
oh, my
looks
my
like
head.
Oscar carries a flask in his belt.
But why is Oscar. He friendly to you?
I
but...
lost my touch.
Yeah, that isn't really explained.
Okay. But you can pickpocket him. And again. And again.
Ah, well, my life wires are full.
Okay.
Sorry, old chap.
What do we say to pickpocketing? Hello or?
Of course. Pickpocketing is totally cool because it.
It's very tense.
It extends. It extends the feeling of stealing because suddenly you also have you have to do it with a moving character mostly and with someone who has reacts to it somehow.
Yeah,
that's cool. But it should not be a mini game in this case.
Yeah. Because we started today with the creative writing and the questionnaire. If you wondered where we are, what we do right now with our own self game that we do the research for right now. What's this? Ah, it's the Ember.
The Ember Vision.
We also started like a little creative.
Beat it, old man. Mm-hmm. Oh, watch out, Styx. After what I did for you, you better keep your tongue behind your teeth. What? What did you do for me? I gave you the plans that will take you to the relics of the Atrium. That cost me this fucking amber scar on my face. Besides, one shouldn't go too far. The relics of the Atrium? You kidding me, Styx? Yes, the relics, the last objects of the great fallen lords. Yeah, of course it rings a bell.
Thanks
yeah,
for the lore.
Well, good luck. I paid enough for this shit and all your schemes.
As much as I like, I come back to the creative writing. As much as I like Substance Painter, I sometimes miss the pre-Substance Painter look.
Yeah.
You know, like this, because the textures were very distinguishedly hand-painted. You know, it really was something of their own kind. You know, you saw that on the textures they have, it was individually crafted for this character.
Yeah.
And now these days, I mean, of course, they are handmade as well in a way, but it's always, you know, you can see a specific tool set everybody's using and recognize the Substance Painter look. And I love, you know, using the tool and how it is used, basically like Photoshop, but in a cooler way, but I sometimes miss this hand-painted look, you know, the difference you can see in the textures of Witcher 2 and 3, for example. Like 3 is very, for some parts, very generic. In closer parts, you see that they just put on one texture style on just one pad. It doesn't look used, it doesn't look, I don't know.
Sure.
Just thought about it when seeing the character. Okay, creative writing. Right now, we both write short stories for the game.
at least one story.
Yeah, or we attempt to. Every one of us just wrote one right now, but it already felt good. I mean, we talked about it.
How long is the story?
Half an A4 side.
Page.
Half a paper. A paper. Yeah. So yeah, but it's not the purpose to write very long stories. It's more like the purpose to get a feel on one certain aspect, like atmosphere, character, protagonist, enemy types. I don't know. So
yeah,
and I really like that. I'm looking forward if we do more of that. But I like the approach because you wrote something, I wrote something. We didn't talk about what we are going to wrote, if it fits each other, and then talked about it, right?
Sure, to align our vision of the game.
And also to discuss it, because it's, I mean, you don't have to talk it in terms of...
It's hard.
He gets twice.
Oh. Already neatly hidden below the... Look at this shitty texture. Like, they didn't even try to align them. Okay, they tried to align them. But it's strange.
Hmm.
Yeah,
that's, no,
that's not bad. It's okay. Just funny.
Yeah, it's strange. It's not really...
It's still not the same texture.
Yeah.
See, the levels get a little bit bigger.
Yeah, sure.
But it's nice to look at.
Yeah, totally.
By the way, did you change the graphics?
To what? To low? I thought it's already.
I have a feeling.
The best.
Yeah, I think it's the best.
I mean, the game is from 2014. What do you expect?
Oh, you can change that.
What?
Can change the brightness here too.
Ah, awesome. Yeah, sure, of course.
Well, it's not
like in most games, but it's not always a
pain. Yeah, right.
Just noticed it.
Yeah, but what I like about the short story writing approach is most stuff you do for the game is like you think very specifically for the gameplay.
Yeah.
But the short story writing allows you to be more free on the aspect that you like to. Also, a lot of stuff is in the head, it feels. Like when you read it, you have maybe a different like atmosphere in your mind. And
right.
We can talk about that. So it's not like instantly visualizing everything, but still keep stuff open for discussions and being creative. So... I kind of recommend it.
I concur.
If you do a game that has at least a story, a world, whatever, lore behind it. How do you like the character control?
It's okay. It's a little bit stiff for me. Probably better with gamepad.
Mm.
I don't remember if I played with a gamepad. What? How could you see me?
Completely hidden with my glowing
tattoo. They don't act.
That's probably good bug. When did you last see?
Okay. Yesterday.
The green blood splashing.
Inside the cupboard.
I just want to check on cyanide studios because I haven't heard anything new from them. Ah, Werewolf the Apocalypse. It's right, it's pretty new.
Okay, you played it, right?
No, I didn't play it. I played Werewolf Into the Forest. It's a text adventure interactive fiction game, a Polish one. So Werewolf is like a, it's also like a pen and paper system.
Just this.
And it's interesting that last year a game came out about it, and well, this year the apocalypse came out. So.
I don't like the fighting at all.
Yeah, it's strange.
Just kill me, please.
I think it feels, it's hard to really tell when the timing. I think it's hard to not slash instantly right away, to really wait until he's half of your size, you know.
My problem with this kind of level design, with this approach of, okay, they have these building blocks for a stealth game, like, okay, we have these climbable things, we have everything has to be the height so the player recognizes them as climbable, and so on.
Yeah.
And I think it sometimes, or often, makes the level artificial. Like, it doesn't feel natural, and I have the same feeling here a bit. I had that in Shadowrun too, where some things just didn't make sense, like, for the whole construction of it. Like, why do they have these big highlands pillars inside the game,
I mean,
inside the market?
In the end, it depends on your design philosophy.
Sure.
Are you, like, more console-y, that people could instantly recognize what is interactive, how far is that from there, you know, working in a grid, having the white stuff on edges so you know you can climb there, this kind of things? Or are you like a purist, you know, you don't want to give away the gameplay? People should feel more immersed in the game, but not by gameplay, but also by, you know, don't want to feel so gamey. So I would say it's a decision. Yeah, I also wondered if they put it on again. How many people does it need to put them on again?
They actually enlighten the torches again.
But that's pretty cool. I like that.
I don't, because now I can't hide anymore.
But maybe they have I mean, I think he pulled out a bottle, so maybe he only can do this once.
Not sure.
I don't know. Everything wears out so fast here. It makes you wonder if there
isn't some sort of crap in the air. Corrosive stuff, like. He said that before.
So the guards have the same random dialogues, or?
I think that dialogue was specifically for when I think I saw something over there. The torch is extinguished. So this didn't make sense anymore.
Okay.
Does he see me or not? Nobody.
When you just stick to it and crawl and then you instantly jumped up.
Yeah,
right?
I couldn't control that.
Okay, I thought you could still stick to the. They did a lot of cycling games. Pro Cycling Manager.
Okay.
Pro Rugby Manager. The Tour de France.
Oh, I put used to.
Okay. Pro Basketball Manager.
How long do you want to play today?
I feel we saw.
Yeah,
a lot of stuff.
I must say it's really. The level design opens up very quickly in the game. Like, we already have all the important elements. We have the clones.
No, you don't know if they have more stuff. They're going to add later, right?
I'm sure they do, but I'm not sure what. If it's that important.
I mean, I would be interested to continue it. It looks really interesting. like especially the exploration part and the level design, and they really don't do a vertical level design, but no, not just a horizontal level design, but also vertically different level design. That's very important, I think. Maybe that's also a problem with Shadwin. It's often too horizontal. Although they have, you know, different layers in a level that you can go, but it's not really. You can't run, right?
That's the running.
Werewolf the Apocalypse, Earthblood, action role playing game. So no stuff.
Vic says, I love Friday Stealth Night.
That's good to hear, Ludwig.
We do too.
Yeah, I mean, it, in a way, it makes more sense than the Wednesday plays. I mean, they are also fun and they also serve a certain purpose for us to get nostalgic or just talk about games in general or just introduce games that we... Whoa, what? Instant kills?
Yeah, that's throwing knives.
You found them?
Yeah, I found them.
Can you still hide in boxes where there are bodies in there?
I can't even just put another character inside. No, I can't. Okay. I'm a killer, baby.
Yeah, but I sometimes like the stealth part more. It's I sometimes feel stealth games are really underserved, although you feel there are so many stealth games out there. We took a look at Reddit, and there's a big stealth group, but it's dead. Like, I think last time, 3 years ago, somebody wrote stuff there.
Okay, are you sure?
Or like a year ago. And I at least he wrote that mostly people just post their videos where they talk about stealth games, and he doesn't like that anymore. So there would be people posting stuff, but not the content that he would like to.
Okay.
But I didn't check properly, okay? I think that's part of a research I want to do soon, you know, to check which groups are there talking about stealth. What is he doing?
I think cleaning.
With a toothbrush or
this particular floor needs cleaning a lot. I think he only does it here because he's light. Other parts too.
Yeah, true.
I think I'm...
But it really looks like the level design is really something that I would love to explore. You know, what's up there? What's behind there? It's really... They achieve to create something that you really want to explore. Right?
Okay. Yeah, a bit. It's too much for me already. It's too, like,
there's something. Okay, that's a problem. I mean, I wonder if the level just looks like it for us now, and there's not more. It's like three rooms, and that's it. And it just looks so overwhelming because it's so, yeah, I don't know, so vast, but it's not, it's one level, you know?
Stealth games.
Nothing here but Ghosts and Shadows. Yeah, right. That's it. And
nine hours ago.
My list of tops that
one leaves. Month ago.
Yeah, but he wrote that it's basically
1 hour ago.
I don't know.
What?
But it's also 20 comments.
I think you have it sorted by top or not top.
Yeah. Okay. So,
what did we learn today?
I like sticks. I think it's on my list.
Stealth sticks.
On my stealth sticks list. It's quite high, I think. I would love to continue it. Although I'm still stuck in Thief 3. I want to continue it.
Yeah.
For some reason.
I don't know why.
I mean, at least we thought about, you know, a lot of people really, really adore the crib.
Cradle.
The cradle.
It's a level that is very remarkable.
Yeah, because it's a horror house, Waisenhaus, creepy
orphanage.
Orphanage. a classic. And a lot of people refer to it's the most atmospheric level. So I would at least love to, you know, you hate it, but I would love to.
I don't say I hate it. I think it's just overhyped.
It's overhyped, but I feel it's important to understand what a lot of a kind of people, certain people love and why they love it.
I'm just saying it's totally horror. It's, yeah. I think that's a big reason people love it, because suddenly the game is definitely a horror game, which for me Thief actually isn't that much.
Think about the beginning when I talked about the zombies.
Sure, but for me that's
one of them, because you saw the system. I didn't see the system behind them.
It's a different kind of horror.
For me they were much more incomprehensible, and so they were much more creepy to me.
Well, really try the orphanage, the cradle, because yep. For me it's a different kind of horror.
Okay. It is just
a horror game.
Scary.
Okay. But you will see.
Yeah.
Right. Styx is not that high on my list, especially as it's third person. And the level design doesn't make such much sense to me.
Yeah.
It looks great. It's a lot of to try out, but it's already too much for me. And yeah, there's so much castle stealth games I can play, really.
Okay.
At some point I have to stop. But we'll see.
Yeah, sure. All right. So I think we set up last time I set it up and already posted it on in the chat so people could vote for the next time.
No, you didn't set it up.
I didn't set it up. So maybe next week I put it on. The poll for the next stealth game, or we just play Dishonored because it was like the second.
We can do that.
Yeah. All right. So, do we want to add something that you learned?
Do our viewers want to add something? Because yes. I didn't yet know. I think what I learned, I already said. Like I really like it a lot more when the levels make more natural sense to me and are not that gamey. Like, okay, there are the climbing opportunities there. You can walk around in shafts and you have bows because players love bows, but you have to give them bows. And
yeah. Also, it was an interesting mix between indoor and outdoor.
Yeah.
So it's mixing up both elements quite well, I feel.
Right, absolutely.
Something I liked at least. Yeah, if nobody wants to add something.
I wonder if the setting is changing a bit, like a park or something.
Mm. A nice park in the underground world.
Why not?
Yeah. I'm looking forward to the elves, actually. If they have special skills, for example.
They have long ears.
So they add a nice atmosphere to it, like creepy.
They look nice.
Not like right now we are looking Lord of the Rings, right?
Yeah,
they are like the high elves and in their nice houses, and they look really creepy.
Those snobbish bastards.
They remind me a bit of the vampires in Blood Omen.
Yeah.
They also have the style of very very Blood Omen style. So. I like that. Also, I think what's the character of Blood Omen? Kane. He also has white hair and this Schnallen, belts. Belts. You know, Schnallen everywhere. I mean, he has completely the same style, like SM, but also Roman Centurion kind of stuff, wearing like this weird mix.
Buckle.
Okay. Clasp. Yeah, maybe clasp. Yeah, something like this. Yeah. All right.
Okay.
I'm fine. I'm good with it. So see you probably next week on Friday. Oh, or I want to test on Sunday. Maybe I take it. I'm planning a spontaneous play because Friedrich gifted me a solo adventure of the Black Eye.
The Dark Eye.
Or the Black Eye is something different. But it looks also, yeah. Of the Dark Eye, the Schwarze Auge. And I plan on at least
I probably won't play it through. I don't know how many hours something like that takes. But starting at least my solo adventure. Not completely solely, but maybe with people watching and commenting and giving tips or giving directions. I don't know. So that's my plan for maybe Sunday.
Yeah.
Or next week. I don't know.
Cool. Yeah. I will continue on my quest to make a Wakecaster game.
Okay.
If people are interested, here's a video I made of my current state. Like and subscribe.
What?
Okay. So I'm doing this thing where you create like a pseudo 3D engine, like Wolfenstein 3D.
Yeah.
And it's actually part of a game jam.
I just would love if you would make a like a Hello C Junigenic. Like a hypnotic hypnotic owl, a hypno way out of it, you know.
I don't know yet what I will make out of it. It's not a game yet, it's just this engine where you can look infinitely into
the abyss of yourself.
No, it will never. I'm doing that right now, and maybe I continue on the weekend, and maybe it becomes a game. But it's fun right now to just follow tutorials to create this stuff.
Yeah.
Like and subscribe. Okay.
Cool.
That's from us this Friday.
Thanks for watching. Have a good night and see you next Friday.
Next week.
Bye.
Bye.
Yeah, I know.